Yesterday in LA, thousands lined the streets to say goodbye to rapper Nipsey Hussle. Now, this dear artist recently released a song called FDT. F Donald Trump. Okay, now that's a very creative refrain.
Very catchy.
Very catchy.
Irving Berlin, look out.
Is it? It all began and ended with Irving Berlin for you, didn't it?
Yeah.
So the refrain, the chorus, it goes on and on. Is that related to the lowest unemployment ever, basically, okay, for African Americans?
But it hustles few.
What we do here is go back.
What is going on, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk back again with another video for you guys. So you saw that clip there. That is Laura Ingraham of Fox News. And, you know, she felt the need to speak on Nipsey Hussle and kind of mock on him. I mean, totally disrespectful in my book. The man just passed away. This, you know, the Fuck Donald Trump song. I mean, it is what it is. You know, it's whether you like it or not, musicians and other people express how they feel through their music. Sometimes it can be political based. Sometimes, you know, you might not agree with what they're saying. You know what I mean? That song's not even, like she said, recently released. That song is from when Trump was still campaigning. He wasn't even in office yet. So for her to say recent, she's just not informed at all in any way, and I'm sure doesn't know anything about Nipsey Hussle. And, you know, people feel how they feel, but I just, it's like, did you need to touch on that? Even if you don't agree, if you don't like Trump, did you need to do that? Did you need to bring this up about that man? Like, just in very poor taste, in my opinion. And if you guys don't know, on my channel, I never really get too political. I personally don't care for Donald Trump, but I'm never out to attack people who do, or, you know, go out of my way to agree with people who don't fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? It's just not what I do. A fellow YouTuber, he goes by the name of Black Bigot. We don't necessarily put out similar content, but we've collaborated on things, and, you know, it's my bro, like, it's like my online homie, and he's a Donald Trump, you know, supporter, and that's cool that he wants to go that route. I don't. So you know what we do when we kick it? We don't talk about Donald Trump or about politics. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you guys have ever heard the whole saying, like, in a bar, never talk about politics or religion. I mean, that should carry on outside of the bar, that policy, in my opinion. But I just, this really, really, I'm not feeling this. I'm not too happy about this. And so are a lot of other people in the hip-hop community have reacted so far. Now, if you don't remember, this is the woman that said to LeBron James, shut up and dribble, when LeBron James was speaking on some politics and things like that. And I don't know, she's just very, very arrogant. And, you know, she felt the need to disrespect this man after he just died. In a mocking way, too, talking about, it just puts a very bad taste in my mouth. So, as I said, some people have reacted out of the hip-hop community, and one of them was The Game. You see, with the images popping up on the screen, his Instagram post, he shared a short video, you know, clip, and he put, so let me tell you what's going to happen here. Fox News fires this disrespectful cunt by tomorrow, Monday morning, or you lose millions of viewers, one person at a time, until it drastically affects your ratings, views, etc. If our demographic doesn't affect that, we will stop support of all our sponsors immediately. We are no longer laying quiet while you continuously disrespect our brother, culture, African Americans as a whole. I will use my platform and call on my peers to do the same. Nip's passing nor his legacy is to be taken lightly, as there will be consequences for any disrespect, now or in the future, as long as I have a voice. I'm asking all my followers, fans, friends, and family to spread this video with the demands of Laura Ingraham's termination immediately. This is not a game, and my brother's untimely demise has noticeably shifted the world and brought people from all ethnicities together in mourning. There is a power in that that will be used, and action will be taken from now going forward. We will not be accepting any apology from her. We want her fired, period. Hashtag the marathon continues. Do not let this slide, my people. I know you can feel the energy Nip left all of us. I know you feel it. Game, not happy at all there. Tank, R&B singer Tank, he shared a post that said fire Laura Ingraham, and it had a link to a petition that, as of a few hours ago, had 11,000 signatures. And it's just, this is what I'm saying, man. Whether you agree with someone or not on something, to go out of your way after their passing to mock them and to talk a bunch of shit about them like that, it's just, I don't know, I don't feel this woman deserves this platform. I really don't. The hip-hop community is, you know, really standing together on this, and, you know, that's how it should be. I don't know, guys. I just kind of speechless. I'm not one for, you know, to stand for someone disrespecting someone who, after their passing. You know, it's just very, very foul. But get in the comments. Let me know what you guys think about all this. Always interested to hear what everyone's got to say. Please hit the like and subscribe, guys. Help my channel grow. Hit the notification bell. Rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle. And come on, guys, let's just be better people. Let's not be foul like this lady. You know what I'm saying? Let's have a little more respect for each other. This chick don't even know about Nipsey Hussle speaking on him like that. The clip that she shared wasn't even a part where that showed Nipsey Hussle. It was a part with YG, like, dumbass broad. Catch y'all on the next one, guys. It's Jay Coffee Talk. Thanks for watching. Once again, rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle.